How was your weekend?
Well, it was alright.
Did you start it?
It was really good. Yeah, I started. Okay, so the two of you who are done with your graphic board, you might just go ahead and log on to the computer.
What?
You're oh, and then two of you will also be logging on in these computers. So choose.
Okay. You can leave it back here.
Okay. After you're done logging in, we're going to do our morning work. Okay. Today it's about combining root words and suffixes and spelling it right.
Father.
Coldest.
Easy.
Busy.
I mean, you're copying the word then, right? Are you copying the word then?
No, you're not copying the word down. Spell your name.
Oh, copy the word right. Okay.
And also, planning and danced.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Ben. Are you okay, Sebastian?
The TP. The beer.
Huh?
The beer.
No, honey. I haven't graduated yet.
Are you senior?
No, I'm a junior. Organizer?
Yes.
If you finished it, well, if you haven't even finished it, just bring it all up. We're going to look at those today.
Actually, I have your packets on my desk because I was looking
at them. I'm not finished.
on working on it, and if you're done with it, we're going to write it on Equal Writer. I'm gonna be using computers today.
I'm done.
Yeah, I have an example.
Okay, flip to the page.
I wasn't done.
I know. Do I need to know?
I do.
So I'm saying, if you wanna show them where they're going with it, then we can help them finish out their graphic organizers, and they can start plugging it into the story.
Okay.
I'm gonna have like, don't worry with the marker, please.
Okay, so I'll read you the example first, and you'll see what I'm doing. So once upon a time, there was a peddler who sold various goods. He used a donkey to carry his goods as they crossed plains, mountains, and rivers. They were crossing a short bridge one day, and carp jumped out of the water. That's a type of fish. This scared the donkey, so it fell into the water.
I just saw on the back.
And then you get to choose what happens next in the story. So you can choose the peddler quickly grabs a large branch and let the donkey bite it and swim to safety, or the peddler rushes to grab his more valuable goods and put them into his backpack.
The second one.
Okay, raise your hand if you want the first one. Okay, raise your hand if you want the second one.
Save the donkey.
Okay, I'm going to do the first one. It was a tie. I'll do both of them. Don't be worried. I'll just
do
both.
Okay,
the donkey swims to safety, but all his precious goods are lost. After this incident, the donkey has realized that every time it jumps in the water, its back doesn't feel heavy anymore. As a result, every time the peddler crosses a village river, the donkey jumps into the water instead of staying on the bridge. So they lose most of the important goods.
This song. I heard this story before. It's about the salt of the
bag. I don't want
it. Yeah, I changed it a little bit though. It's my own story. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to it. Now we're going. I did this. I'm gonna do the second option now. So the peddler saved some of the more expensive clothing and various decorative sculptures. Luckily, donkeys can swim, so his donkeys learned to save
them. Yeah.
And then it's the same thing, the donkeys realize it's not heavy anymore. His back's not heavy when he jumps in the water. So now you can choose again. So it keeps on going like that. So I'll just put the...
You're gonna give him a chance to read those options.
Oh, okay.
Wow, I'm so afraid.
So he's trying to find a solution to having the donkey not jump into the river. So, choice number one, the peddler decides to keep feeding carrots to the donkey while it is crossing the bridge so that it is happy enough not to jump off the bridge. I changed it, okay. The peddler puts a large sponge on the donkey's back the next time they cross a bridge.
Mm-hmm.
Yay!
Second one.
First one.
Okay, I heard 3 second ones.
What?
I said first.
It's not the only ending though. Okay.
Heavier
the donkey shakes in surprise because the weight on his back is even heavier. As a result, the donkey stops jumping into the river and the peddler sells his goods without a problem.
Yeah.
That's the original ending. But since we're making there be different choices, there's going to be at least 2 endings. So I'm going to go back. And so you can keep on choosing. Eventually we'll get to the second ending, but it's also a happy ending, so don't worry about it.
Yay.
And this second ending is where you'll get the second complication. So the first ending, you can just have it be something easy, so it's not so hard on you, and you don't have to write as much. But the second part, you can write more, write your complications in and everything.
So you're going to be putting your clever story into one of these, and you're gonna add some choices, like Ms. Mingus, so that your readers can go through your story making their own choices. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to show you how to make these kind of stories. So first of all, I'm going to sign out. So you'll type in on your computer.
You can cancel that one.
For example, just type in Inkle Writer, and I can help you type it in if you can't spell it. So you click Start Writing, and then you click Sign In, and then Create New Account, and then you just put in your email and your school email and school password. but I already have an account, so. And then it'll start you in write mode or read mode. So here you can see your contents, which is all the everything you've written down in the story, and you can divide them into sections. And then when you go to read mode, that's how it will normally look when you're reading it. But you have to click this button on the top to start at the beginning when you read. And then here you can bold your words or italicize them. You can also add new sections. You can also add a picture, but you have to put the URL of the picture. And I'll show you how to find a picture so you don't have to cite it later. Oh yeah, if you have pictures already in your folders, you can use those. So you click the enter button to start a new paragraph. And if you want to add a choice to the story that leads to like a different part of the story or an ending, you add options and you can type those in. So I guess I'll add, I ate apples. And then you can add another option, I ate pears. And then you can start on that part of the story. It'll give you a new paragraph. And then you can add some part of the story that apples were sour. And then you can add an option to that. And then if you want to connect the story, so if you were trying to do the first ending and you wanted just to end there, but you want the reader to be able to go back in the story to the choices so they can choose the second ending, you would click enter a new paragraph. One loose end, and just continue adding options. And then if you want to go back, just go and click this and read. So and then if you want to go back, just click that button, read. Okay, if it's really confusing, I'll be helping you guys write this story. There's a lot of directions that you have to follow, but it'll be really fun, and at the end, you'll get to play each other's stories.
You guys have any questions about this first one?
No. Do you guys want to just read the whole story, or do you want to get started on your stories? Yeah, let's get started.
So then you are ready to start typing. Everyone else, we need to finish your graphic organizer.
So that's not true in here.
You're the first thing.
So you already typed it, so you're in Google Drive. I need to open that. Yes. I need to open that and you can copy and paste it and change it around. You don't have to type it again. You're just gonna make it interactive. Okay.
Okay. I'll let you be surprised for you.
Okay, I have a question to these to help you.
Can you sit over there?
And where it says 1 and 2 is where you're gonna add an option later, but for now it's all basic story.
Okay.
So what were two things that you or Rachel tried that didn't work? You're missing one.
Okay.
Okay, so she was already annoying you, and
Josh,
so you threw
stuff
down
on the tree.
So what's the problem? Do you want to get it back down, or is Rachel annoying you? Which one of those problems
maybe
do I focus on?
What was a problem that came when you tried to bike across campus?
I put it on the construction site.
I just
maybe
know
the
which
problem
is your main problem,
was
problem
that
in the story. Is your main problem Rachel, or is your main problem the stuff down?
What could they do to make
Rachel's
it less
main problem? Okay, so you want her to stop annoying you?
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Okay,
so
we can write about how they train
the
for
it,
like their parents.
Okay, so that could be another option here. So let's say, or we can add a construction site.
Or you could write how they had training wheels.
So that can be one of the things you
have. Then the training wheels fall off.